In this video, we are going to make a spy project using which you can spy on any person you want by just placing that battery-powered device, which is barely visible. Using that, you'll be able to listen all their conversations secretly, and that person won't be able to recognize that you are spying on them. Let me show you a quick demo of it.
I doubt Kedar is planning to go out on a holiday, but he haven't informed me yet. So let's spy his telephonic conversations and let's see, is he really planning to go on holidays or not?
So I'll place this behind this particular statue so it's not at all visible from.
Okay, he got call from someone. I doubt he must be talking about his planning for holidays.
He's going into office. Let me just call onto my spy number.
I'll call onto this number. Let's turn on the speaker.
Let's listen to his conversation secretly.
He's planning for Goa.
हाँ फ्लाइट में चले जाएंगे 22 को निकल जाएंगे अरे सचिन भाई का मैं देख लूँगा मैं उनको बता दूंगा 22 को बोल दूंगा कि डेंगू हुआ डन 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 डन
गोवा इज ऑन सो गोवा इज ऑन
ओ डैम
Yeah, maybe I'll go.
Well, this is really crazy and scary as well. So a big disclaimer that do use this project for ethical reason only. Don't misuse this project. And I am making this project tutorial for educational purpose only. So yeah, before starting this video, now if you're watching me for the very first time, well, consider subscribing this channel as I used to come up with these interesting and informational project tutorials in the field of IoT, automation and electronics. Well, that being said, let's start with our audio spy IoT project using A9G board. Both these are the interesting and useful project here, so let's get started. Do you know what most electronic companies have something in common? Well, it's the tool that they use for making their products, and the most commonly used tool that almost all the big electronic companies uses is the LTM PCB designer software. Using LTM, you can definitely level up your PCB designing skills and make something really professional out of it. And now, along with the integration of Octopart, searching for any electronic components globally becomes really very easy. Octopart is kind of Google for just electronic components, where you can search for any electronic parts and get that information all on one single web page. So do check out this amazing search engine made just for electronic components. I'll leave the link for this down in the description. Do check it out. So now for making this project, we'll be using this A9G module, which has built-in GSM and GPS in it. Well, this is an amazing board for all those GSM GPS based application. And well, I already made a detailed getting started video about this board, which is live on our YouTube channel, whose link you can easily find in the description of this video. So now many of you will say, like, why not to use SIM 800 module rather than the A9G module for this particular project? Well, of course, you can go for SIM800L as well, but I have used this A9G board for two main reasons. First, it already have a built-in tiny microphone on it, and secondly, it also has built-in battery charging circuit, so I can attach a battery directly to this board and charge it with the help of the micro USB port on the board. So for these two main reasons, I considered this board, but you can go for SIM800 as well. Now, to give command to the A9G board, we need a microcontroller board, and for this project, I chose particularly ESP32 Xiao C3 board because that was the smallest microcontroller board available in my studio. Hence, I chose this board as I also wanted to make this project as small as possible. And both A9G board and Xiao C3 are available for sale on our website, whose purchase link is also down in the description. So do check it out. And now the last part remaining in the hardware side is the battery. So here I chose this small lithium battery to power this project. Now here is one problem, like we can, you know, power the A9G board directly with the battery because it has a battery charging circuit in it. But A9G model don't have any 3.3 volt pin onto the board. So with this, we won't be able to power the Xiao C3 board. So now to give power to the Xiao C3 board, here we have to use a voltage regulator in between. So here I've used this low dropout voltage regulator ST733 in between to power up the Xiao C3 board as well. And in the end, I also consider this on-off switch to power on and off the project. So in short, we need to have these all components for making this project, and you need to connect them all according to this connection diagram. Now, one by one, we started soldering all the components on a general purpose PCB. And now here we soldered the Xiao C3 board directly on the back via its SMD pads to save the space. And also we inserted the battery in between the female buck strip so that it can easily be hidden by the A9G board on the top. So this is how our final hardware looks like. So now after the hardware, let's move on to the coding part of the project. Okay, so here is the code for our audio spy project. So first of all, we included the library wifi.h. Then we have declared a sleep pin at digital pin D2 of our Xiao C3 board. Now this D2 pin is connected directly to the GPIO 25 of A9G board, which is responsible for, you know, waking up that device and making that device to go into sleep mode. Okay, so we'll be controlling the sleep mode using this particular pin. Then some of the necessary variables, pretty common. Then after that, what we did is we declared the serial monitor at serial.begin. This will be for, you know, observing the data in the serial monitor. And after that, the serial 1.begin is attached at D0 and D1 pin, and this is for A9G board. Let me just type it, A9G board. Okay, so with this, our Xiao C3 board will communicate with our A9G board via UART communication. After declaring the sleep pin as output, pretty common. Now here what we did is we are making the radio off for power saving. Now for this particular project, we don't require any Wi-Fi or Bluetooth connectivity of the Xiao C3 board. So we are just turning off the Wi-Fi using this command and turning off the Bluetooth using this command. And with this, we are saving a lot of power, which was wasted unnecessary. Okay. After that, we are waiting for 20 seconds for A9G to set up everything. So GSM model do require a couple of, you know, commands to be performed to, you know, be ready for accepting any different commands. And for that, we have estimated time of around 20 seconds. So during this particular time period, your A9G board will be ready to use and ready to accept the call as well. So we just put a delay of 20 seconds here. And after that, we are turning the sleep pin low. Now turning the sleep pin low will, you know, stop the sleep mode, and turning the sleep pin high will, you know, trigger the sleep mode of the A9G board. Okay. So whenever we want to give AT commands, we should turn the pin low. And whenever we don't want to give any AT command, we can turn that pin high to save power. So here we will be, you know, entering the AT commands. Hence we have turned that low. After that, we are just typing the AT here for, you know, checking purpose. After that, here we are turning off the GPS because this project don't require any GPS for power saving. We are turning the GPS off. And after that, we are triggering the sleep mode at 1. Okay. We are configuring the sleep mode to 1 for this A9G board. And after giving all the commands, we are, you know, making that board to go inside the sleep mode by making that pin high. Pretty common. Now let's just see what's happening inside the loop part of the project. So we are just listening from the A9G module, and as soon as we get the command called as ring, which means someone is calling on our device. So as soon as we get this ring command, what we are doing is we are printing on the serial monitor as it's ringing. We are turning off the sleep mode. And after that, we are typing a command ATA, which is responsible for picking up the call. Okay. So as soon as someone calls on the device, it will automatically pick up using this AT command. And after that, we don't need any AT commands to be entered. So we are, you know, triggering the sleep mode. So that's it about the simple code. Other than that, we are just clearing the buffer and printing the response from the serial monitor. And here we are, you know, adding one by one character to display in a string format. That was it about the code part of this IoT audio spy gadget, you can say. Pretty simple. Just whenever someone is calling on it, you should pick up the call. Otherwise, just be in a sleep mode. So that's it about the code. Now I will directly upload this code onto our Xiao C3 board. So after going through the code, now let us test this complete project. So here I'll insert a SIM card in the A9G module. Now here I'm using a VI SIM card, but you can use any SIM card from a network operator that provides 2G connectivity. And let me tell you, Geo SIMs won't work here. So after that, I'll turn on the switch and I'll press and hold this power button to power up the A9G board. As you can see, the blue light got turned on. Now here we need to wait for at least 20 seconds for A9G to be completely ready for accepting calls. So now I'll make a call on this number and let's see what happens. Okay, as you can see, the call got picked up automatically and now I'm able to hear audio from this module loud and clear. So this is how you can use this project and place it around anywhere where you want to listen to the conversation happening around this board. So that is all about our IoT audio spy project made using the A9G and the Xiaoxi 3 board. Well, I do have a couple of more projects to be made using these boards, like an SOS button, a GPS tracker. So well, do subscribe this channel so that you don't miss any of our upcoming project to be made using these amazing boards. And also do share your thoughts in the comments about what will you be making with this amazing A9G board and the Xiaoxi 3 board. Do share your ideas down in the comments of the video. And well, if you don't have those boards, well, we are selling it at the cheapest price on internet, whose link are down in the description of this video. So yeah, that being said, I am just ending this video here and now. Just wait for my next video, then explore, learn, share with me, techiesms.